Welcome to Pod Applaud, the Monday through Friday podcast that aims to enable your podcast habit. I'm your host, Seb, and today we are getting hysterical with the podcast, American Hysteria. American Hysteria is an explorative podcast by Skylark Media that explores and explains the panics and collective delirium of America's past, present, and future. At the time of this recording, the show is releasing mini-episodes between seasons 1 and 2. There are currently 11 uploaded episodes. For full episodes, the show usually runs about 40 minutes and is roughly half that length for the mini-episodes. This show made a pretty impressive splash onto the podcasting scene when it released near the end of 2018. I believe it was trending rather quick into its lifespan. That is when I first came across the show. Our host, Chelsea Weber Smith, seeks to demystify topics that seem to explode into and poison the American consciousness out of nowhere. Former episodes include The Satanic Panic, The Illuminati, Poisoned Halloween Candy, Stranger Danger, Phantom Clowns, and The Gay Agenda. Basically, anything America might be freaking out about or has freaked out about in the past. You may have heard these topics covered in a podcast here or there, especially since there are a lot of podcasts that just love to cover conspiracy theories. But I would hazard a guess you have not heard the topics broken down nearly as thoroughly as Chelsea breaks them down in American Hysteria. I have heard enough podcasts babble off the Illuminati Wikipedia page to last a lifetime. Really, I was tempted to skip the American Hysteria Illuminati episode when I saw it. But as a completionist, I went down the rabbit hole one more time. And I was impressed. The coverage is satisfying and not dry in any way. Chelsea finds a way to make the material engaging and bring just a tad of wry humor here and there. I'm tempted to go so far as to say, if you hear a subject covered by American Hysteria, you have probably heard the definitive coverage. The production is really quality too. I will definitely be keeping my eyes on the Skylark Media Network. At times, there are some topic specialists that speak. There are old audio pulls from commercials or radio and other audio sources well-balanced and leave the show a treat to listen to. An interesting aspect of the show is that every second episode is called a calm down episode. The idea being is that we get all riled up from learning about the Satanic Panic one episode. Then we have a more human level episode where the research and revelations are discussed in the next. Chelsea brings a friend or colleague to discuss the subject matter in her calm down episodes. Essentially, what this does is it takes the conversational tone. Essentially, what this does is take the conversational tone of a duo host podcast and separates out the banter, anecdotes, and conversation into the calm down episode and leaves a more dense research and presentation episode in the first one. I'm not sure how I feel about this. The calm down episodes really can't stand by themselves. You have to listen to the main episode or you're just not going to get it all. But I do think they add to the subject. I wouldn't want the two episodes mashed together and edited down because the show would likely have to sacrifice some of the quality research. So I think this unique setup works. One of my favorite aspects of the calm down episodes is when Chelsea reveals even more things she could have gotten into the main episode. It is like a little breadcrumb trail you can follow if you want to learn even more on your own time. Here on Pod Applaud, I rate shows on a 1 to 5 scale. One is silence, two is a slow clap, three is applause, four is a round of applause, and five, of course, is a standing ovation. I would give American Hysteria a 4 to 5, a round of applause. The show is ear candy, and no, not the poison kind. What holds the show back is that it has so much overlapping content with other shows that have already covered these topics, and that the calm down format feels like it is on the right track, but still has some wrinkles to iron out, and feels a bit like a feed filler. I'll stay subscribed and listen to episodes as they come out. I would recommend the show to curious people who want the whole story or are first hearing about the topics covered. That's been the show for today. I hope you found it valuable. If you wish to reach out or follow me, you can find me on Twitter at podapplaud or send an email to podapplaud@gmail.com. Thank you for listening, and please tune in again.